Bitcoin. Is it really a currency? Is it a complex algorithm? Is it a mathematical problem? Is it really valuable? Is it just an internet bubble like other bubbles? Is it just a fake valueless thing on the internet which is on trend? Today, we are going to discuss what is Bitcoin, how do you get a Bitcoin, should you invest in Bitcoin, how does Bitcoin work, how safe is Bitcoin, and more. So, video will be long. So, please do like, subscribe, and share this video so that your friends can also know what is Bitcoin, how much it is valuable, is it really valuable, or is it just a bubble. So, please do share it with your friends, and please don't forget to click the link in the description or use our introducer code to open a free demat account on Angel Broking, as it will be beneficial for us to grow our channel bigger and better. Without any further ado, let's get started. So what is Bitcoin actually? Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, and cryptocurrencies are a huge algorithmic mathematical problems which you have to solve to being a miner, which doesn't really mean you have to go and excavate to mine your Bitcoin, but actually you have to solve that complex mathematical problem by using programming language and programming knowledge to mine and get your Bitcoin. And 6.25 bitcoins are mined every second, which means it's a rare one, because there are only 21 million bitcoins and 18.9 million bitcoins have already been mined, which takes us to about 90% of the bitcoins has already been mined. Previously, when Bitcoin was at its infant stage, you could mine your Bitcoin by using just your laptop and running the program in your background. So it was that easy. But now you need a server, then you need a decent amount of airflow to accumulate all the computers and all the hardware that you require to mine a single Bitcoin. Yes, it's now costly to mine a single Bitcoin. So how will you get a Bitcoin right now? Right now you can get a Bitcoin by going into any cryptocurrency exchanges and buying a Bitcoin. You might not buy a whole Bitcoin because it's too much valuable, which means it's $40,000. You can buy a part of the Bitcoin and store it, then sell it to the cryptocurrency exchange again, just like in the stock market. But is it really valuable, or is it just an internet bubble? My opinion, it's just an internet bubble, because if you see the history of Bitcoin, it has risen to its high, then crashed and lost its 80 to 90% value, then again risen, then again lost 80 to 90% value. So history repeats itself, as the philosophers tell. So this time also Bitcoin can burst and lose 90 to 95% of its value as it's trading at 40,000 level. So Bitcoin is very much fluctuating because Bitcoin's market capitalization is only $720 billion. I know, which means a lot to many people, but actually, if you see the yellow metal, which means the gold's market capitalization, it's around $12 trillion. And if you see the stock market's capitalization, it's around $50 trillion. I'm talking about the NYSE. So compared to that, Bitcoin's market capitalization is just tiny. So where if someone buys a lot of Bitcoin or dumps a lot of Bitcoin, then there will be fluctuation, because if someone orders, suppose, 1,000 Bitcoins, then there will be high demand, which means the price will drive up, and other people also buy the Bitcoin, which will further drive up the price. Then if someone wants to sell Bitcoins, then the price will drive down or plunge, and people will panic and more people will sell, which will further reduce the price to its bottom. So demand increases, the price of Bitcoin increases, demand decreases, the price of Bitcoin decreases, as it is a very small market compared to other markets. But in the future, if the cryptocurrency market becomes bigger and bigger, because only Bitcoin is this much valuable, other cryptocurrencies are trading at very low price, so the cryptocurrency's market capitalization has to grow to make it a stable currency, because the dream of the founder of Bitcoin was to use Bitcoin while trading between nations. Like if I want to buy a mic from an American guy, so at present I pay him with rupees, then it gets converted to dollars, then he receives the amount and I receive the mic. But the actual concept of bringing this cryptocurrency was, I will buy the mic from him, but not with rupees or dollar. I will buy with Bitcoin, which will have same value with him and me. So no fluctuation of values. So to obtain that, the market capitalization and use of Bitcoin has to grow more. So more people has to use Bitcoin while buying pizza, burger, then camera, mobile phones, everything. So Bitcoin's market capitalization has to grow. Not only Bitcoin, other cryptocurrencies like Ether, Ripple, Ethereum, Litecoin, and even Facebook's currency, which is going to be launched very soon, Libra, they have to be used more frequently. And as soon as Facebook launches Libra, then you will get more knowledge about the cryptocurrency, because now cryptocurrency only trades in the dark web. Or if you are an angel investor and want to buy a Bitcoin and invest in your portfolio. Other than that, in day-to-day life, we don't use any cryptocurrencies. Like we use only rupees for India, dollars for USA, euro for European Union, Swiss franc for Switzerland, like this. So you have to use cryptocurrency in your daily life to make it a stable one. And when Facebook launches it, as I was talking, then you will get the idea, because Facebook's marketplace might get the Libra currency into circulation for buying and selling products in the marketplace, which will affect the cryptocurrency market, and it might bring a stable value, as there are a lot of Facebook users in this world and many people buy from marketplace except me. So Bitcoin uses a blockchain. So what is blockchain basically? Consider a trolley cart. Okay, you make a transaction in Bitcoin, so your trolley cart, which is a blockchain, gets added and it can't be undone or it can't be reversed. So it stays for there. Now, if you want to sell that Bitcoin, then another blockchain is added, which means there will be proof for every transactions throughout the life without any concerns. And as it is a decentralized currency, no bank, no government can manipulate the value of a cryptocurrency. So it will be decentralized. It will have record forever, which is a good point, that it will be available to public. Anyone can see how much Bitcoin or how much Litecoin, how much Dogecoin was transacted to buy this amount of thing or this amount of goods. It will be available to the public. And if you're concerned that if the Bitcoin data gets hacked, Bitcoin is hackable or any other cryptocurrency, but to hack that, you have to spend a lot of dollars, because Bitcoin uses a blockchain, which means there are data in every computer or every device you transact. Then the hacker has to trace back to all those binary trees and then get the data, then store it in one computer and then hack it, which means a lot of money needs to be used to hack the Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrencies. So it is relatively safe. And about manipulation, Bitcoin has been manipulated with Ether, but it is less manipulative than any fiat currencies, because if you have seen the graph, then 20% of the US dollar has been printed in the year 2020, which means it's really concerning. And Bitcoin's value is raising so much just because of the $3 trillion stimulus check that the Congress of US has passed, which refers to that dollar is losing value and people are using Bitcoin as hedge to dollar. So yes, Bitcoin might gain more value until the crash comes, who knows. So I hope I could give enough of information in this video. So please do like, subscribe and share this video with your friends who are interested in Bitcoin trading and who wants to know more about Bitcoin. And also don't forget to click the link in the description or use our introducer code, this one, to open a free demat account on Angel Broking, as it offers zero charges in delivery trade. And stock market is much more stable than the cryptocurrency exchange. So you can invest and keep calm without thinking of that value will fluctuate between $2,000 or thousands of dollars within 1 hour, because Bitcoin might gain or lose thousands of dollars within an hour. So it is very unstable. But here it's not the case because it is being regulated by the central agencies. So I hope supporting our channel will be great by clicking the link in the description. So signing off for now. Bye.